Hey guys, it's Carrie. I'm looking at reptiles today. They are a group of tetrapods with an ectothermic or cold-blooded metabolism and amniotic development. Living reptiles include turtles, crocodilians, lizards and snakes, and the turritara. Sidewinder rattlesnake. It is a pet viper species. Adults grow to an average of 80 centimeters or 31 inches in length. The females are larger than the males. These snakes are venomous but possess a weaker venom than many other rattlesnakes. Albino Burmese python. These snakes are rare. The albinism is a genetic mutation in the DNA where the body does not produce melanin, which is pigment, which results in white skin or scales. Komodo dragon. They are apex predators and dominate the ecosystems in which they live. They are the largest extant species of lizard, growing to a maximum length of 3 meters or nearly 10 feet and weighing up to 70 kilograms. Please subscribe and turn on notifications. Kemp's Ridley sea turtle. It is the rarest species of sea turtle and is the world's most endangered species of sea turtle. The length of their carapace is 70 centimeters. Caiman. They are predators, much like alligators. Their diet largely consists of fish. Frog. Even though they're often lumped with lizards and skinks of the world, frogs are actually amphibians, not reptiles. Frogs, like all amphibians, are cold-blooded, meaning their body temperature is the same as the air around them. Basilisk lizard. They can run on their hind legs. Their speed, coupled with specialized scales on their feet, allows them to sprint across the water's surface. Horned lizard. When it feels threatened by a predator, its final defense response is to shoot blood from the flooded sinuses and out its eye sockets. Crested gecko. They are mostly arboreal species. They are able to jump long distances between branches to move to new locations. They have a crest of skin over their eyes that resembles eyelashes. Rock agama. They like to bask on bare rocks where they are hidden by their cryptic coloration. They feed on insects. The male in the breeding season assumes bright colors. The upper parts become fine vermilion red or yellow. The lip stripe is sometimes pink. The undersurfaces, limbs and tail are black. Lizards are a widespread group of squamate reptiles with over 7,000 species ranging across all continents except Antarctica, as well as most oceanic island chains. Lizards range in size from chameleons and geckos a few centimeters long to the 3 meter long Komodo dragon. Most lizards are quadrupedal, running with a strong side-to-side motion. Some legless lizards have secondarily lost their legs and have long snake-like bodies. Some lizards, such as the forest-dwelling Draco, are able to glide. The males often fight each other over territory. Sea turtle. They do not have teeth, but their jaws have modified beaks suited to their particular diet. They don't have visible ears, but have eardrums covered by skin. They hear best at low frequencies, and their sense of smell is excellent. Red-eared slider turtle. It has a small red stripe around its ears, or where its ears would be, and from its ability to slide quickly off rocks and logs into the water. Blue coral snake. Their venom has only occasionally caused human deaths. This species has unusually long venom glands extending to 25% of the length of the body. Its venom does not contain a neurotoxin. Corn snake. They lack functional venom and help control populations of wild rodent pests that damage crops and spread disease. Sometimes they are mistaken for the venomous copperhead. Iguana. They are large lizards that can range from 1.2 to 2 meters in length, including their tails. They possess a dewlap and a row of elongated scales running from the midline of their necks down to their tails. Like most reptiles, an iguana has a three-chambered heart and two atria, one ventricle and two aortae, with a systemic circulation. The muscles of an iguana are very light in color due to the high proportion of fast-twitch glycolytic muscle fibers. This facilitates short bursts of movements, but is inefficient for long-duration running. Iguanas are often hard to spot as they tend to blend into their surroundings, and their coloration enables them to hide from larger predators. Chameleon. They are distinguished by their zygodactylous feet, their prehensile tail, their laterally compressed bodies, and their head cusps, their projectile tongues used for catching prey, and their swaying gait. And in some species, crests or horns on their brow and snout. Chameleons' eyes are independently mobile, and because of this, the chameleon's brain is constantly analyzing two separate individual images. When hunting prey, the eyes focus forward in coordination, giving it stereoscopic vision. Color change signals a chameleon's physiological condition and intentions to other chameleons. They can change color due to special cells under the skin. Inside these cells, color particles move around. The chameleon takes on the color of whichever particles are packed together most closely. This is one of my new chameleons. If you dip this one into warm water, best not to use hot, it changes color. What an amazing tongue! Lizards are mainly carnivorous, often being sit and wait predators. Many smaller species eat insects, while the Komodo eats mammals as big as a water buffalo. Lizards have a variety of anti-predator adaptations, including venom, camouflage, reflex bleeding, and the ability to sacrifice and regrow their tails. Some lizards have modified scales under their toes to form adhesive pads. Eastern diamondback rattlesnake. It is a pit viper. It is the largest rattlesnake species and is one of the heaviest known species of venomous snake. Maximum reported lengths of the eastern diamondback rattlesnake are up to 2.5 meters, which is just over 8 feet. Coral snake. They vary widely in their behavior, but most are very elusive. They are burrowing snakes, they spend most of their time buried beneath the ground or in the leaf litter of a rainforest floor, only coming to the surface when it rains or during breeding season. Amazon tree boa. They are aggressive and will attack humans without warning. Though only adults pose any serious danger to humans, as this species is non-venomous. Adults can grow to an average of up to 2 meters or 6.5 feet. Green tree python. They are non-venomous. They are constrictors and ambush predators. They capture prey by using their tail to hold onto a branch and then striking out and constricting their prey. Fire salamander. The poison glands are concentrated around the head and dorsal skin surface. They prefer deciduous forests since they like to hide in fallen leaves and around mossy tree trunks. Collared lizard. They often run in the presence of danger, although they can sometimes be quite aggressive and feisty. When fleeing, the lizard will lift its body and tail and run on its hind legs. Bearded dragon or pagona. Their name comes from the beard-like spines on their chin. These spines are used as a defense mechanism. When threatened or attacked by predators, bearded dragons will puff up and display these spines to scare off potential attackers. Crocodile. Its physical traits allow it to be a successful predator. Its external morphology is a sign of its aquatic and predatory lifestyle. Its streamlined body enables it to swim swiftly. It also tucks its feet to the side while swimming, making it faster by decreasing water resistance. Crocodiles have webbed feet, which, though not used to propel them through the water, allow them to make fast turns and sudden moves in the water or initiate swimming. Alligator. This mum's got her hatchlings on the back. Alligators move on land by two forms of locomotion, referred to as sprawl and high walk. The sprawl is a forward movement and the belly making contact with the ground, and is used to transition to high walk or to slither over wet substrate into water. Male chameleons or turtles and crocodiles have a penis. Lizards and snakes have hemipenes located caudal to the cloaca on both sides of the ventral aspect of the tail. The hemipenes work much like a penis does. The male's testes are intra-abdominal. The males pass sperm from their cloaca to the cloaca of a female, which is much like a vulva. Fertilization occurs within the cloaca, and fertilized eggs leave the female's body through the opening in the cloaca. Chameleon. I wondered where this one got to. To catch an insect, it quickly unfurls its sticky tongue with such speed that the insect is utterly caught off guard. Alligator. There are two extant species, the American alligator and the Chinese alligator. Kemp's Ridley sea turtle. Hatchlings are darkly coloured on both sides usually. They have a triangular shaped head with a slightly hooked beak. Frill-necked lizard. When threatened, this species erects its frill to make itself look bigger. The display is accompanied by a gaping mouth, puffing, hissing, and tail lashes. Milk snake is a species of king snake. It is not a venomous snake, but its bright colors act as a false advertisement to potential predators. Rough green snake. It is a non-venomous North African color breed. They are very slender and graceful with beautiful solid green backs and yellow or white bellies. Chain king snake. They are ground dwelling snakes that often kill and eat other snakes, even venomous ones, including rattlesnakes, copperheads, and cottonmouths. King snakes are highly resistant to their venom. Boa constrictor is a heavy-bodied snake, and large specimens can weigh up to 27 kilograms or 60 pounds. Green anaconda, it is the largest, heaviest, and the second longest after the reticulated pythons snake in the world. Notice that the head is narrow compared to the rest of the body. The eyes are set high on the head, allowing the snake to see out of the water while swimming without exposing its body. The anaconda's jaw bones splay open at the front because they are loosely connected, allowing it to swallow large prey. Cobra. This one is by Safari Limited, and you can change the shape. Wherever the little dots are, you can bend it, so you can actually straighten it out so it's going along the ground. They are highly venomous, and many are capable of rearing upwards and producing a hood when threatened. Please stay and watch another video with me. I love to read and reply to all of your comments. Thank you for watching my video. See you again soon. See you guys in my next video.